It's the Andy Thompson Show on ESPN 97.7.
Nine Athletics and a big supporter of the community. Let's go. Peter, what do you got?
On the Andy Thompson Show.
Revis last four on third down. And it's Barkley.
Hey, Sport Hole, what's your Skeeter Beater tonight?
Thank you, Sambo. Skeeter Beater, fuel up the Oldsmobile, Larry. Head on down to Skeeter. It's been a while. We got Monday Night Football, so we're not picking a WNBA game. We're picking a NFL game. And like I said, it's the Eagles and the Falcons. Judas Priest, Larry, in Atlanta. Eagles favored by 5.5. Saquon went nuts game one. Can he go crazy in week two? Can Kirk Cousins play through some pain and show out for the Falcons? Can he get the ball to Kyle Pitts? Take the Eagles. You're supposed to wait for the applause until I say who I'm picking. Take the Eagles. Let's go to Katie Rosen for our first hour look at the National News Desk. Katie.
Thanks, guys. This show stinks. From the Sport Hole National News Center on Bluff Street, I'm Katie Rosen. Panthers to bench quarterback Bryce Young and start Andy Dalton versus the Raiders. That should work. Man charged with stalking, harassing UConn's Paige Beckers. It's called a press. Miami Dolphins to sign Tyler Huntley. That should work. No, I'm being serious. He's good. Today's Sport Hole National News is brought to you by Lawrence's mom. From the Sport Hole National News Center on Buff Street, Katie Rosen, ESPN 97.7.
Thank you, Katie. I feel like she kind of mailed that one in, Larry. Did you feel that?
Yes.
The Sport Hole.
Sports.
2-minute drill.
1-0 delivery.
Hammered down the line in right field, and it is fair and slides into third for an RBI triple.
Presented by Ideal Home and Auto Paint.
Touchdown! 27 yards. They make it look so easy.
All right, here are the scores from Friday night. If you missed them, it was a great Friday night in Southern Utah. Three good games. Three close games, kind of as predicted. Snow Canyon went on the road and beat Cedar 21-14. How about Joe Mack? Joseph Smith threw for 225 and two touchdowns in the win for the Warriors. JT Westbrook caught six passes at 114 yards to lead them in receiving. Everett Kelling had another good game throwing the ball. And it was to another guy. It wasn't to Overson. It wasn't to Crew Giles. It was to Dylan Crowley who led them in receiving. As Cedar goes down 21-14, they fall to 0-2 in region play. Crimson Cliffs beat Desert Hills 28-17 to go to 2-0 in region play. McCord Christiansen led the Mustangs with 211 yards and two touchdowns. I thought he had 40 carries. I went down and talked to him after the game, and I said, "How many carries did you have?" He said, "I have no idea." I said, "It seemed like 40. He said, I don't think it was 40, but only 29. But when you have a kid like that, you just keep feeding him the ball. 211 yards, over 7 yards per carry, and two touchdowns, including this one. I ruined Rustin's call on this one because I was hyped up, but here it is.
Fourth down and three. Here we go. Crucial play.
Fourth down and three.
They give it to their bell cow. Christiansen.
Oh, my gosh.
He breaks free, and it's Christiansen into the end zone for a Crimson Cliffs touchdown, and the Thunder players are stunned. He was stopped. It was done. It was over, and he found a way to break on through.
I Romo'd him on that one, Larry.
Yes.
Could have contained my excitement.
No.
That was incredible. Titan Mason had a great game for Desert Hills. He went for 144 yards and two touchdowns for the Thunder. Awesome first half, 14-14. Then offensively, Desert Hills in the second half only put up 3 points, had some interceptions and turnovers, and Crimson was able to get the victory 28-17 to go 2-0 in region play and get the big rivalry win on the road. Hurricane got the win over Pineview, 34-27. R.J. Allred, Dylan Gabriel, and Brody Jacobs all scored touchdowns on the ground for the Tigers. Carson Curtis had 14 tackles for Pineview. So congratulations, Coach Cowan's first region win, right?
Yes.
over Pineview. Your stat leaders in week five, we just do total yards. We do totals. So total yards for the offensive guys, total tackles, total sacks for the defensive guys. Everett Kelling threw for 258 yards and two touchdowns and an interception for the Reds in defeat. McCord Christiansen was your top rusher. 29 carries, 211 yards, and 7.2 yards per carry. Dylan Crowley, 7 receptions for 125 yards and a touchdown for the Reds. Carson Curtis for Pineview again. What a season he's having. 14 tackles for Pineview, 1 tackle for loss. And Callan Kelly, 2 sacks for Snow Canyon. And their win against Cedar up on the road. Also had 9 tackles. All right, Sam, but what do you got, buddy?
Sport hole.
Yeah, go ahead.
How insulting are these RPI rankings?
Well, I don't know that they're insulting. Ridgeline first, really kind of well ahead of Spanish Fork. So Ridgeline 77 points, Spanish Fork 75, Park City 69, Green Canyon 68, and Skyview 65. So Cache Valley well represented with 3 teams in the top 5. Timpanogos is 6. Crimson Cliffs is 7. What surprised me about Crimson Cliffs is that their opponent's winning percentage. Because you think about the teams they played, and it's like, what's Morgan's win percentage right now? What is... I know Bingham has lost to some good teams. Springville... and then Cedar, but the opponent's winning percentage for Crimson Cliffs is 55% winning percentage. Then you got Uinta at 8, Mountain Crest at 9, Provo at 10, Stansbury at 11, and Desert Hills at 12. That's the next Region 9 team. And Snow Canyon's 13th, Cedar's 14th. So you have 3 right in a row, 12, 13, and 14. Mountain View, Murray, Salem Hills, Pineview is 18th. Westfield, 19th, Dixie, 20th. Hurricane 21. And there's 28 teams in the classification. So our last team is 21st. Logan, Tooele, Payson, Bear River, Cottonwood, Hillcrest, Jordan rounds out the 28. So Hurricane, who just beat Pineview, is a few spaces behind them. RPI is always weird, right, Larry? We'll call her and get her on the show later on in the week.
Yes.
But, it irons itself out for the most part. But Ridgeline... 5-0 right now. Park City's 5-0. We saw how good they are when they came down to play Dixie and Green Canyon. Skyview's down, I think, a little bit this year. They've been down a little bit the last couple years, but still a top 5 team in the RPI. Region Rush will be out on Thursday, right? We'll have the top 9 plays coming your way Thursday, presented by Bucks Ace Hardware. All right, anything else from over the weekend in Region 9?
No.
We'll have more on it later on in the sport hole, though. More discussion of that. We got Big Tad. Big Tad, our NFL correspondent, going through all the NFL games. Rapid fire. Let's go. What do we got?
National Field Goal League Blitz with Big Tad.
All right, let's get to it. Seahawks 23, Patriots 20. What a boring matchup. Throw the record books out when these two teams get together because they both suck. DK Metcalf, good job. Geno Smith, Danger Russ is sobbing into his paychecks from American Family Insurance. Gerard Mayo sucks. Saints 44, Cowgirls 19. Rashid Shaheed, Weebcats stand up. Derek Carr living right on and off the field. Derek Carr goes to church. Alvin Kamara, you magnificent son of a bee. Chandler Parsons, washed. Learn how to get off a block. Zeke, fat, CD, we want some of our money back. Jerry Jones, why don't franchise a Whataburger or something else? This hasn't been working. You suck. Bucks 20, Lions 16. Baker's back. Lions doing Lions things in the red zone. Jared Goff, you should go back to playing in the pack too. Amon Ross St. Brown, baby. Aiden Hutchinson, pretty good, but do it when it matters. Dan Campbell, stop crying. You suck. Packers 16. Colts 10. Anthony Richardson, colorblind. What is he, stupid? He's worse than Graham Mertz. Josh Jacobs. Yum, 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 yum. Malik Willis might have a place in this league after all as the guy who holds kicks for the kicker. The placeholder. He's terrible. Lambeau is the dumpiest stadium in all of sports. Not because it's old, but because it's filled with 75,000 Stephen Avery's. Jets, 24 TC, Titans, 17. Will Levis is an idiot. How can you be so stupid? Oh, right, you played in the SEC. Aaron Rodgers, the essence of mid. You're lucky you played the lowest IQ opponent in the NFL. Maybe Tennessee should hire that caveman, Mike Vrabel, back. At least his teams could run the ball. Purple People Eaters, 23, 49ers, 17. The clock has struck midnight, Purdy. Luckily, you got that commercial deal with Ariat before everybody realized you suck. Maybe you should start kneeling during the anthem to get some off-the-field opportunities after you get benched. Sam Darnold, good job, Ginge. Kirk Cousins is a fraud. Hey, Brandon Ayuk, you suck. Why don't you try getting open? What are you coin-operated? Juwan Jennings, thanks for showing up. Jordan Mason is better than McCaffrey. How dumb does John Lynch feel? He and Jerry Jones should get together for a bonfire. They can just throw money into it. Redacted Skins, 21. New York Football Giants, 18. The Redacted Skins kick 7 field goals. Makes me want to puke. That's 13 field goals in 2 games. What a pathetic win. Brian Daboll's an idiot. Daniel Jones couldn't start in the UAC. I'd rather die than even watch the highlights from this game. Jaden Daniels is like my sister learning how to drive stick shift. Constantly stalling. San Diego Chargers, 26. Carolina Panthers, 3. Run the dang ball, Jim. Good job, Bryce Young. Euthanasia. Nick Saban almost won a natty with that little twerp. Goodness. Honestly, Mel Kiper and Todd McShay should have to turn in their press credentials. Those idiots told us he'd be good. I can't help but feel bad for the kid. They need to relocate this team to Sac Lake City. Can you imagine? Why don't we have an NFL team? Meanwhile, all of these loser cities like Jacksonville and Charlotte or wherever the heck the Panthers play do. Who's their coach? He's an idiot. Jeez, Jacksonville wants Urban Meyer back. They need a kick in the pants. Travis Etienne, you've had a rough time. Why don't you try running forward every once in a while? Deshaun, settle out of court. Watson, good win, even though you sucked. Jerry Jeudy, better late than never. Get a haircut. Raiders 26, Ravens 23. Lamar, are you stupid? How did you lose this one? Gardner Minshew wins one for the ghost of the pirate. Devontae Adams, thanks for showing up. Great toe tap catch. Brock Bowers is better than Gronk. Derrick Henry. Fat. Cards 41, Rams 10. Kyler Murray, best quarterback in the league. That little ninja is hard to keep track of. Seriously, good job throwing it to the rookie finally. Marvin Jr. made mincemeat out of the Rams. They suck. Cooper Kupp, crybaby. Blake Corum, Purdue ain't walking through that door. Matthew Stafford, your wife, should have stayed with your backup at Georgia. You stink. You're nothing without Puka, you fat idiot. Steelers 13, Broncos 6. Who cares? Bo Nix, you should have stayed another 7 years in college. You suck. Justin Fields, you might be worse. What a horrible game. Swifties and the refs, 26. Bungles, 25. Mahomes sucked in Burrowhead. Refs bailed him out. What a joke. Jamar Chase sucks. And by the way, keep your mouth shut, you idiot. Way to lose your team the game. Zach Taylor stinks. Lineman caught a touchdown pass. Makes me feel good to see the big fellas get one. Those dumbos rarely get a shot to do anything important. Good for Coach Reed drawing one up for the boys. Oilers, 19, Bears, 13. Caleb Williams is beyond bad. Why don't you sacked a couple more times, dumb? You're not playing Stanford anymore. Go cry to your mom and watch Netflix with your cat, you baby. You suck. Eberflus is going to be canned in short order. DJ Moore, we want some of our money back. Talk to you next week, everybody.
The Sport Hole.
It sounds boring as hell, but go ahead.
Thank you, Big Tat. In rare form today, didn't you think, Larry?
Yes.
The Sport Hole.
Butch.
Still got another first down at the one. First and 10 from the 11. Wilson. End zone. Caught. Caleb Loner, the former basketball player.
Sport Hole. Does Cam Rising deserve scorn for sitting out the USU game?
Does Cam Rising deserve scorn for sitting out the USU game? Is that the question?
Yes.
It bugged me he didn't play because he was cleared. He was out there. He was warming up. And I think it was a decision to preserve him for Stillwater and Oklahoma State when you open the conference. So in a way, it was looking past Utah State, which is understandable because they're struggling and not having a great year. But you almost lost the game. So I think a lot of Utah fans were probably at halftime like, what? Look, Whittingham, we got to win the game, you know? Now, Isaac Wilson actually played pretty well and made some great throws and from the pocket was making throws down the field, looking pretty good, didn't you think, Larry?
Yes.
So that was good to see. But I understand being I was frustrated at Cam. I didn't think he was going to play. He comes out dressed. He's warming up with his glove. He's hurt his finger. If that were a conference game, he would have played. And my thing with Cam is if you can play, play. Because who knows how many games you're actually going to be able to play. Once you are this injury prone, as Cam is, you can't take games off for precaution. Just play. Because the next time you play, you're probably going to get hurt again and it's probably going to be more serious. And Cam's value isn't as a just stand in the pocket and throw it down the field guy, Larry. He's got to run around and put himself at risk. That's where he makes all of his great plays. Not only running for first downs, but making plays out of the pocket and stuff like that. So he plays a risky kind of quarterback, meaning when he actually comes back, who knows how healthy he's going to be able to stay. It's a sad story how often he gets hurt. But the finger thing was like, man. If he's medically cleared to play, play him against the Aggies because you're going to lose to the pig farmer. Now, he looked great. Bryson Barnes, I was pulling for him. I was rooting for the Aggies to win that game. And he was great. He was his throws down the field in that first quarter. Larry, Mel Kiper is going to want to see that film because he was putting it over the shoulder, throwing it deep, is, you know, running the ball was good and all that stuff. So Bryson Barnes, good for him. If Petrus is healthy, he's got to win the job back from Barnes, which might be hard to do with how Bryson Barnes is playing. Let's see. Other positives from that game. The tight ends. I mean, Keithy had a good game. He didn't have huge numbers, only a few catches, but they used him in different ways. They used him as a runner. They used him with that Utah shovel pass in the red zone, which was good. Carson Ryan saved Isaac Wilson's butt on fourth down from the 2-yard line on that out route that he, I thought it was going to the bleachers, and Carson Ryan made that catch. That was good. Caleb Lohner in the red zone. That's the clip you played, Larry.
Yes.
Where he jumps up against a 5'10 DB, makes the catch. That was great. Mekhi Bernard ran the ball well. It seems to me like Jalen Glover has been demoted, and Mike Mitchell is the second guy, and Dijon Stanley's kind of the third guy, is more of a third down pass back, but Mekhi Bernard is kind of being a heavy, he totes it a lot, I guess is what I'm trying to say. So I was frustrated that Cam didn't play, Larry. I'm not going to lie to you. I thought it was lame. Who knows how much pain he's in or what the injury is. They don't give any details. But I thought if you're medically cleared and you're in pads, play the dang game. Especially because Utah State gave you a run for your money. Good for Utah State. And the thing about the Big 12 is it's topsy-turvy. And Oklahoma State has looked pretty dang good, you know? Beat Arkansas, beat the heck out of Tulsa. Kansas State, who I know nearly lost to Tulane a couple weeks ago, beat the snot out of Arizona, and Avery Johnson looks really good. That's who BYU plays this weekend at Lavelle Edwards Stadium in front of the ROC. That's going to be a big challenge. We'll get to that later in the show. I know, Larry, but...
Yes.
The Big 12's crazy. I mean, it's not like Utah's head and shoulders above any of these teams, Larry, based on their performances. So give me a break. Huh? All right.
Yes.
We got Randy?
Yes.
Okay.
What up, buddy?
You're not very bright, are you?
Andy versus Randy.
As we do every Monday, we welcome in my twin brother, Randy, who always calls us and gives us constructive compliments about our show. What's up?
What up, buddy?
What's on your mind today,
oink,
buddy?
Oink, oink.
What do you got?
Piggy almost beat the Utes.
Yeah.
Okay. Piggy.
Yeah.
The guy you're
proud
always
of
making
him.
Fun of and saying no good.
I was cheering for him.
Almost beat the Utes. I don't care.
With their backup quarterback, right?
I don't care. What, yeah.
With Wilson instead of Rising?
Backup or not. It went up to Logan.
Yeah.
Pig Farmer looked awesome throwing the ball. He looked awesome running the ball.
A couple of picks.
He made a couple mistakes.
Yeah.
A couple mistakes. But the point is...
He was great.
He gets so much pity. No, he gets looked down upon.
Okay.
Like he was not good enough to play at Utah. He clearly was.
He was not.
And is. And they won a lot of games with him. And Utah State should be grateful to have him because he's better than Petras.
Barnes played a lot.
It doesn't matter if Petras is healthy or not. The future is with the Pig Farmer. All right. I got to go.
Oh, you got to go, huh?
I got to get back to work.
Oh, you're on break?
Yes. Yes.
All right. Well, don't get in trouble.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks for calling.
I got to go.
Okay. Thanks for calling, Randy. We'll talk to you. All right, see you later.
All right, bye-bye.
All right, bye-bye.
The Sport Hole.
Sports. Build and get their offense back on the field if they want to stay in this game.
In the 80th meeting between the Cougars and the Cowboys, BYU's won 9 straight. Marion brings it out of the end zone. Marion across the 30, gets a big block at the 40. Keelan Marion has a chance inside the 30-yard line. Touchdown, BYU. Keelan Marion. Takes it end zone to end zone.
Sporty, is BYU a phony 3-0?
That's a loaded question, Larry. I mean, I don't know how you can call it a phony 3-0 when they were supposed to lose by 12 to SMU and they won the game by 3 when they, you know, they were a 9.5-point favorite against Wyoming and they won by 20. And they smacked Southern Illinois. So, no. My answer is no, they're not. Wyoming was horrible. Wyoming was one of the worst teams I've seen this year at any level. I mean, Svoboda, Snow College, stand up. But that was rough. That was rough. I mean, he couldn't complete a throw. He was high on a lot of stuff, right?
Yes.
So that was not a good team. And BYU dominated it. And that's what BYU as a Power Four team is supposed to do against teams like SIU and like Wyoming, is just beat the tar out of them. And they did. All three phases. Defense is one of the best. What did I see, Larry? Top 15 defense in the country through 3 games. That was their biggest problem last year, was defense. Couldn't pressure the quarterback, couldn't stop anybody. It's been their problem the last couple years. Second year at Jay Hill, shutting them down. Shut down SMU, shut down Wyoming, shut down SIU. So BYU fans have got to be thrilled with that. I think that's the number one thing through 3 games is how good their defense has looked. Retzlaff looks good. Looked good against Wyoming. I know not one of the better teams they'll play all year, but He was fine. Three touchdown passes. Chase Roberts was great. He was open a lot. Keelan Marion had that kick return touchdown. They've got Kansas State this weekend at Lavelle Edwards Stadium. Kansas State's going to be ranked in the top 15. They're 13th or whatever. And I was impressed with Kansas State. They've got they got the DJ Giddens at running back. They've got Avery Johnson in at quarterback, who looked great as a runner. I mean, he's fine as a passer too, but he's going to be a problem. BYU has struggled a little bit. The SIU quarterback ran against them. Svoboda's real only success was pulling it down and running it a couple times. So that's going to have to be a focus for them, because Johnson is a game breaker in the open field. But as a BYU fan, you're 3-0 going into conference. I don't think a lot of people have that. You're two games away from hitting the over in Vegas. Like, three games away from going to a bowl game. And you've got to beat Baylor, who's terrible. You got to beat Arizona State and a team like Houston to get to bowl eligibility. And maybe you can beat a team like Kansas or a team like Arizona at home or something. The tough games are Oklahoma State, Kansas State. At UCF might be tough, even though they haven't beat anybody. Well, I guess they just beat TCU in a close game. At Utah's obviously tough, but BYU's, you're sitting pretty. I mean, you're sitting better at this point than a lot of people anticipated. And if you go to a bowl game, that's a success this year. And they want more, though. They're not settling for a bowl game, Larry.
No.
Good job by BYU. Not a phony 3-0. At all.
The Sport Hole.
Sports, 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 sports.
And there goes Big Deacon Hill. That was not expected. Deacon Hill, touchdown. Oh, my goodness. Where did that come from?
Sporty. Is Utah Tech the hardest job in America?
Sometimes it seems like it, Larry. You know? I wanted to text Coach Paul Peterson and say, hey, I thought you were the problem. I guess you're not. And I don't think Lance Anderson's the problem in, you know, his first three games. I think it's a super hard place to win. I thought they'd play better against Northern Arizona, a team they beat last year. But it was 31-3 at halftime. It was, the crowd's just out of it in the first half, you know? So it was another tough loss. It is a hard job. And it's the, you know, it's hard to win the community over. The transitions are tough. All the same crap we always talk about with Utah Tech. Not a lot of money. Pillaged in the portal. I mean, you're seeing... every team could say this, but Bo Sparks and, you know, Hobert, we saw them in primetime with Texas State. Quali Conley at Arizona is like one of the better backs in the Big 12 this year. It's hard to look up at SUU doing much better than Utah Tech is. And I think that is one of the reasons they made the move from Peterson. Because you look up at Coach Fitzgerald and what SUU's doing, and they're competing a lot better. So that is going to factor into, like, urgency. What excuse do we have not to be competitive down here when SUU up in Cedar is doing better? When there's more money down here, there's more facilities, there's more population, there's more people moving here, etc. You're in an unstable conference. Who knows what's going to happen with the UAC? People are leaving constantly. And a hard schedule. Not just your conference schedule, but your out-of-conference schedule is hard. So it's a tough, 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 tough job. I don't think it's the hardest job in America. I think that's hyperbole, but it's a very hard job. And I don't know who would take it. I don't know who would take the job, because it's so hard to win. And this isn't just Utah Tech. It's any FCS program. You're a junior college. You've been made into a junior college. You can't build anything year to year. It's a clean slate every year. All your good players are going to leave. Who would take that job? It's a noble job to take. You know, Coach Anderson, I think, is the right hire because of his background and the type of coaching staff he's brought in. He's just starting over. It's not like you get to pick up where Coach Peterson left off. Everybody, you know, you reset every year. Whether you're good or bad. If you're bad, everybody leaves. If you're good, everybody leaves, you know. So it's tough. But it's a sob story that's not just Utah Tech with the portal. It's everybody. But there are other obstacles in the way of success at Utah Tech. And I'm not saying I always defend Coach Peterson, but I understand the wins weren't there and they wanted to move on. But now it's going to be hard to get it's going to get hard to get two wins this year, you know? So it's just it's a great question, Sam, because I don't know who high school is a better job than mid to low tier FCS programs, because you know, your pay's not as good, but at least you can implement a program. And while I'm saying this, I do understand that 45 minutes north, Delane Fitzgerald is instituting a program. Like, they're having some success. They've gotten better every year he's been there. They almost just beat UC Davis, you know, 3 days ago. So I don't want to come across like I'm making all these excuses for Utah Tech. Meanwhile, SUU is having some success in a similar situation, in a similar area. But it sucks. I feel bad. I hope they're able to get some conference wins. Northern Arizona is just a lot better than they were last year when Utah Tech beat them. They competed against Arizona. They came in and, you know, it's been hard. The offense hasn't been able to move the ball. Defense, when you're on the field so much, it's tough. All right. Go ahead, Larry.
The Sport Hole.
Sports.
They did bring in, what was it, 49 transfers?
Well, let's hold up on that, Larry. Okay, so the question is, how many more years will Delane Fitzgerald be at SUU? Right, Larry? Was that your question?
Yes.
The idea being, you know, if they win the conference, he's going to get offers. If they win 7 games, he's going to get offers at other places. I hope he's there for, you know, several more years. Get some UAC championship or wherever they're going to go. Heck, maybe they'll be in the Big Sky in the next couple years. What I like that they're doing is they're running the dang ball. Targhee Lamson had 150-something yards against a good program in UC Davis. They outran, they ran for 210 yards and stopped the run. They got up 14-3 in that game. They had 22 first downs. They were 50% on third downs, better than 50% on third downs, and had an even turnover margin. So they're playing ball. A late pick to end the game. They were down 3 in plus territory through a pick with like 20-something seconds left. But, you know, another well-competed game by SUU. Do we have time to do the... I don't think we have time.
No.
Okay. Well, for some reason, we didn't play the UTEP audio going into the UTEP week with SUU, which is hilarious. Larry, I blame you for that. But
yes.
Coach Fitzgerald talking about UTEP and El Paso before they went and beat UTEP, which was great. And he got some heat for that online. All right. Two more things. What do you got, Larry? Bring it on.
Yes, you made a boo-boo.
I did.
The boo box.
Time for the Boo Box in the Sport Hole.
Boo Box is brought to you by IndyRVSales.com. Cox Brothers will make it a breeze for you to find your dream RV at IndyRVSales. Check out IndyRVSales.com. Okay, this is the exact same Boo Box rationale we had last week. Last week it was Antonio Pierce who punted in plus territory down 6 in the fourth quarter and never got the ball back with a chance to win. Remember that?
Yes.
Well, Kentucky and Mark Stoops did the exact same thing at home against Georgia. You got a chance to beat the number one team in the country. Kentucky has this weird thing with Georgia where the closest games Georgia plays on the road, the last 3 times they've played them, is Kentucky. They're all like crazy one-score games. Stoops has a chance on fourth and... Was it fourth and one, Larry? even if it was 4th and 3, you still go. I think it's 4th and 1. Can you look that up?
Yes.
In Georgia territory, with like 3 minutes left. Like, it was not a lot of time left. Like, Pierce with the Raiders had like 7 minutes left. You didn't have a lot of time left, Stoops. You're going to punt it to Georgia. You're never going to get the ball back, you stupid idiot.
The bull box.
So they don't. They don't. The game's over. As soon as you decide to punt, what you're saying is, I'm happy we kept it this close. We're not really trying to win. We want to blame the defense for not being able to get a stop. And so we're going to punt it. I could not believe my eyes when I saw that. It's pathetic. What a loser. All right. Oh, man. All right. Go ahead, Larry.
Ladies and gentlemen, this week's Gus Johnson Award goes to...
All right, we got a couple, right?
So far in the Viking defense, 2nd-and-9. Darnold getting messy, going deep, and he's got Jefferson. He's got Jefferson. It's a foot race downfield with Brown. Shifting gears, getting a block. That's 6. 97 yards. Holy
Congratulations, Kevin Harlan is our first winner. He gets $10 to Island Grinds gift certificate. I recommend the Poo Poo Chicken. All right, then we got a couple from our local call of Rustin Burnside here from Friday night. Desert Hills, Crimson Cliffs. Here's Desert Hills on offense. Take it away, Burnsy.
2nd-and-3 after the 7-yard pickup from Young. They send Young outside, give to Mason. Mason has a burst of room, and Mason, far sideline. It's a foot race as he tries to shake a Mustang defender out. He does, cuts back inside, and it's a touchdown for Titan Mason.
Wow. Pretty good color analysis by me there at the end. And then, so $10 for Rustin. To Island Grinds, and then I get minus $10 for ruining this play call here. This is one of the best runs of the year. Titan Mason has a run like that a couple times a game. I mean, he's incredible. But the most crazy run was McCord Christiansen, 4th and 3 in a close game. They're going to go for it, and they're just going to give it to McCord. He's completely stopped at the line of scrimmage. And here's Rustin describing it in the play-by-play. Go ahead, Burns.
4th-and-3. Here we go. Crucial play for the Mustangs. They give it to their bell cow. Christiansen slips through. He breaks free, and it's Christiansen into the end zone for a Crimson Cliffs touchdown. And the Thunder players are stunned. He was stopped. It was done. It was over. And he found a way to break on through.
Fantastic. So minus 10 for me there to Island Grinds. Quick break. Back with more right after this on the Andy Thompson Show with Rustin Burns.